So guys, welcome to the Solus Project. This is a game I've been following for quite a few weeks now, and it recently released on Steam. If it wasn't for the movie called The Martian, I probably would have forgotten about this game. But you guys know me by now, I'm a huge movie fan, and if you haven't seen that movie yet, go and watch it. It pretty much gave me the inspiration to want to play this. If you don't know about the game, you can find all the information in the description below, but we're going to get straight into it, guys, because after watching The Martian, it made me really want to try this game, so here we go. Okay, so this is set 15 years later after the star has collided with Earth and pretty much wiped out the solar system that we knew. And I'm guessing this is one of the colonial ships, which is voyaging throughout the huge expanse of space to try and colonize a new planet. Already this game is gorgeous.
Vata? Yuri? Can you hear me?
Warning. Atmospheric entry imminent.
Where is everyone? Did anyone make it to the drop pods? Eamon! Lars! Is anyone there?
We're not the most of elegant space travelers. Okay, so we're now in the game. So we have three options. We have easy, normal, or hard. Now I like to think I'm pretty good at survival games by now. At least I've been playing them for around 5 years. So I'm gonna go with normal. Balanced survival mechanics. Difficult multiplier, 1.0 visual helpers. Okay, we're gonna go with normal. If it's too hard, we can always go back. Difficulty and other settings can be changed at any time during the game. Use Fahrenheit, use feet and miles, use US fluid ounce. Okay, I know how to use all this, so we'll just stick with what it's got. So we're on an alien planet, guys. And look at this. I'm guessing this is all the debris from the ship. I wonder what shot us down from when we were orbiting this planet. Okay, let's start picking things up. So, what's this?
Scout Independent Local Survival Overseer Node active. Wilson interfacing with operator. Operator vital signs detected.
Okay, so is this... That's really cool. Okay, there's an error with this satellite relay. It's out of range. Yeah, makes sense. So is this our HUD? I can't tell if it's called Wilson or Welson. But this looks like it's our HUD. I mean, it's got a compass on it. It's got survival stats on the left. And on the right-hand side, that looks like world statistics. So things like Fahrenheit or the temperature. It's actually really cool. Okay, so let's take a look around. That's the escape pod that we crashed in. We're actually super lucky that it landed where it did. Either that or this thing's made out of some kind of material which is impenetrable, because could you imagine the crash? Or the speed that we were falling to this planet at? Okay, let's look around, let's see what we can find. Okay, items have two states. Pick up an item, or craft slash combine with another item state. Okay, so this is the pick up item state. We have rock. Okay, and this is the second state, which is craft or combine. Okay, what's this? This is a sharp rock. He said it can cut something. Cable can be cut, requires a tool. Okay, so we have to select the different... Okay, this is pretty cool. The way they've made the crafting system in this is very different to anything I've played before. What's this? P for stats, O for objectives, and B for sleep. We've picked up some cable as well. For climbing and a useful tool. Okay, so can we pick this up? Yeah, that's pretty much what I thought it was. I didn't see this. So that's the objective distance. This is actually a really cool concept. I like this. Okay, let's pick up the cable. Can we crouch? With any game like this, guys, I like to take in my surroundings before I get really right into the meat of the game. Stretch of Desolation. It's already got a really nice theme to it. Okay, let's start picking some things up. Water bottle stores water. Pretty straightforward. Okay, so we've got that. So this is... Okay, so there's something in that can. This is pretty much going to be the introduction to the game, so we can expect things like tutorials, you know, helpful things along the way. Survival Handbook 1 of 8. If you find yourself in a precarious situation, explore your surroundings and scavenge whatever useful items you can find before conditions worsen. Yep. That's pretty straightforward stuff. Number 2. As soon as you can, secure a source of heat, fresh water and food. Find a place to take shelter. How you deal with the first few hours is crucial for your survival. That is also very, very true. We need to find a place to set up camp. I just want to look around first. I just want to explore this island. Okay, so we got another can. Is that just some more food? Yeah, okay, we're going to pick that up. Some kind of pole. Another water bottle. Look at this, guys. There's something over there, too. Okay, how do I access my inventory right now? Okay, just with I. So it seems like all the debris has just fallen down now. Holy shit. Right, let's see what this is. Is this one of the engines from the,
Please follow survival training.
Okay, so we got a new forward vector. Find a place to take shelter.
All up in flames. I need to last long enough to report something back to Prolus Command. Better have a look around and see if anything or anyone survived.
I had no idea this game actually had voice acting in it. It's actually a cool change. I mean, we don't really get... Holy crap, I bet a lot of you guys don't actually know what this thing is. But these things were before DVDs. But either way, it's kind of a cool change to actually hear your character talking in the game. I mean, I can kind of see how it would get a little bit repetitive if it happens all the time. But I like this. Okay, what's this? Crafting a torch. Create a makeshift cutting tool using rocks, put off dry organic material, wrap the material around some kind of handle, and apply oil to it if available. Light it on fire. Okay. So, like I said before, guys, this is just the basics. Oh god, okay. Going once more into caves. Find a place to take shelter. So is this what we're calling home for the time being? Drink from a fresh water source. Drinkable water. Okay, so... this is actually really cool. Can we fill up our bottles that we've collected with this? Oh, do they actually have it in? Okay, so I think it automatically fills everything up. Let me just keep drinking this. Let's see if we can... what do we like for hydration? 82.5. Our calorie count's going down pretty quick. I'm going to keep drinking it just... okay, so it says okay now. What's this? Burnable and can be cut. Okay, so let's grab the sharp rock again. Is it this one? And... okay, so we now have material to, I'm guessing, make a torch with. What is that? Is that cobwebs? Oh no, they had to put cobwebs in the game. Even on an alien planet, there had to be spiders. Okay, we're okay for water right now. So this is pretty much what we're calling home. And that looks like some more of that burnable material. Okay, so how do I craft that then? I mean, do I have to apply it with this? Alright, let's just go to this vector and we'll see. It's probably going to tell us mushrooms. It's probably going to tell us how to make the torch. I mean, that's one of the most basic things that we need. Scavenge some food. What is this?
Inventory full.
Okay, so do we need to drop some stuff? How do I drop things? Okay, backspace to drop. There we go, I don't want that rock. I want this. What is this? It didn't really give us a description of... well, I guess we wouldn't know what it is because we're on an alien planet, but... some kind of plant is edible and it gives us 134 calories. Doesn't have any hydration, though. We're gonna go ahead and eat this. I want to see what kind of effect it has on the calories. So, watch the bottom left. Yeah, that's actually really cool. I mean, it's good to find things like this while we're out scavenging for stuff. So you can kind of eat on the go. Is there no more forward vectors? I'm just going to have a look around. Anything we can scavenge from this? What's this? Oh, okay. So maybe this is the... I need to get off that. Maybe this is the oil from the actual jet engine, and I need to dip that as the material for the stick, so... it has infinite burning as well. Oh, okay, so let's grab this. Place that in there. And can I pick that up now? Did that work? Oh, you can drop things with right click. Oh, there we go. Okay, so I can... so you can combine them. It just doesn't... what was that? Resistance buffs. Hypothermia, heatstroke, starvation, and hydration. Body wetness and dry speed. Okay, so at least we got something now that can burn. Locate a pipe. I already have a pipe. Okay, I think it's going to run me through everything that I've just kind of gone through in my head. Maybe I've gone and done it a little bit too quick. Yeah, I think this is running me through exactly what I've just done. Alright, let's grab the sharp rock again. Let's pick this up. Okay, yep, we've combined that. So we've got two torches now, which isn't the worst thing in the world. let's head back out. And I'm guessing it's maybe the ridiculously hot fire from the jet stream that's gonna light this thing on fire. Light the torch. Some objects emit intense warmth or cold. I don't think I should be stood here, guys. This thing would literally melt me to a crisp. There we go. Okay, so we have fire now. Whoa, what the hell? Act 1, The Awakening. So is this us now establishing ourselves as we are now survivalists on this alien planet because we can make a fire? Holy shit, connection established. She had to say. Connection lost. Yeah, this... What was that? The signal was so weak, it was so distorted. I think I heard, you don't have a lot of time left. You have to find something. I think there was something back here that I missed. Look at these things. They look like fossils. I just want to make sure I'm not leaving any stone unturned, you know, especially for the first video. What's around here? Anything good? Can we get over this? There we go. Okay, we got another bottle. This is actually... This game reminds me a lot of a game that I'm actually looking forward to playing, which is No Man's Sky. If any of you guys have heard of that, then you'll know how excited I'll be to play that game. I cannot wait to see what that game has to offer. There's been a lot of hype around it. I think this is just food around here. Is that an old TV? Flight recorder, resistance to falling, +4. Okay, so we get buffs for different things that we find. Could you imagine this though, guys? If you were sent out as some kind of space explorer to colonize different planets, and you crash landed on a world like this, and it doesn't look like a barren world either. I mean, these things don't just happen. Whatever they are, plinths, pillars, whatever you want to call them. Something is here. What would you do? I like to think that I'm the person that if there was ever a voyage from Earth to go and find different planets and they were looking for volunteers, I'd like to think I'd be the person who'd have their arm up in the air first. But the more you see things like this, and I mean, I know this is just a game, but it put things into perspectives. I mean, especially when I watched The Martian, it put things into perspective. You are utterly alone on a whole world to yourself. What would you do? And nothing but space all around. Okay, we're gonna do a little bit of exploring, guys, and see what we can find. If there's nothing much else, I may just end the episode here, because I do plan on playing more of this. I believe this is the first part that's out now, and the next ones are coming in the next few weeks. Nights are very cold, but we should be okay, right? Because we got a torch. I'm already getting a very creepy vibe from this game. I don't know about you guys. I haven't seen one single life form on this planet yet, but I got a feeling they're here.
reminder, your survival is of paramount importance to the continued existence of mankind.
Oh yeah, that's right. We were on a colonial ship, and it was blown completely into pieces. So are we the last human? Oh, that puts a different spin on things. Whoa. Alright guys, let's go and check this place out. Is it weird that the worst thing for me right now is the cobwebs that I've got to walk through? Here we go. Got some mushrooms, we got something on the floor here.
Dehydration imminent.
What the hell is that? Oh, okay, we need to get some drink. Okay, we need to consume it. Okay, we're alright for now. Let me grab this back out. Now, it did say that the fuel to burn this fire could pretty much last forever, so we should be okay on that side of things. See, things in the wild or nature do not form like this. This has been placed like that. At least, it doesn't work like that on our planet anyway. Maybe this one's a little bit different. Can you not get through there? What the hell is this thing? Ruthlessness of Minority. This is a climate resistant hunger and dehydration plus one buff. Okay. Oh, it goes deeper, guys. Okay, we're gonna see what's around this corner here. I'm pretty sure I'm gonna die. Oh my god, this is some kind of crypt. Is that another one of those buff things? There's a really weird noise coming from these caves. I hope you guys can hear it. It's like a very faint whistling sound. So what's this? It's got a very Planet of the Apes looking face. Some kind of sigil on the bottom there. Okay, how are we doing? Okay, we're not too good for food, so let's just go ahead and eat what we have. So, let me eat this.
Could have been worse.
Yeah, I don't think my character liked that very much. He said it could have been worse. What the hell is that? Relic of Athleticism. Movement speed plus one. It's a really cool looking mask. Whoa. Kind of Jason Voorhees mask. It's kind of very similar to Subnautica and The Forest mixed into one. I know I use that comparison a lot because it's the two main survival games that we play. The colors, though, they do remind me of that new game No Man's Sky, as I said before. And it's nighttime now, so how does that change things? Do things come out at night? If anyone's seen the movie Pitch Black, you'll know why I said that. I'm hearing a lot of freaky shit, something like R2-D2 in the distance then as well. Is that Wilson going insane? Okay, we're gonna have one last attempt at looking around this. What the hell is that? Oh my god, what is that? Everything on this planet is out to kill me, guys. I really want to venture on, but I don't want to get too far away from the place we're supposed to be making camp. Look at that. Is that a planet in the distance very close to us? Holy shit, this game is so nice. The ocean texture, everything about it is just so nice. Okay, I think we should head back. What do we have on the... on the Overseer? I think this is called the Worldwide Local Overseer. I don't know why they didn't just give it a quirky name. Well, I guess they did with Wilson. Alright, I think it's time to head back. Let's see if we can set up camp for the night and maybe... 15 years, Earth time, but only 8 years for us. Time flows slower when you travel a substantial fraction of the speed of light. When I told my friends, they said it was trippy. They wanted more explanation, but we don't get much time per week, so I cut it short. Okay, so that's obviously when we're in space. I'm no expert on space, guys, but I do know that things travel a lot slower when you're in space. Having all that, she doesn't guarantee happiness or meaning of life. I get the impression she's trying to make me reevaluate my priorities. So this is somebody's diary that we're using to kind of get clues from. What the hell are those? Oh my god, some kind of fly trap. Alien fly trap. Alright, we're going to pick some more of this up. Maybe not, because we don't have enough space. What can we drop? I guess I could drop this. I don't really need it right now. And can I pick it up again? Okay, do we have any more space? Do I need the sharp rock? Okay. At least I know. I hope they don't despawn, but I definitely need to get back into the cave, and I definitely need a fire as well. There's just things everywhere around here. I can see this game being pretty heavy on the crafting side of things. Some more VHS. Tapes. Look at that. Alright, let's get back into the cave. Let's see if we can save the game. What is this? Is this my sprint bar? Yeah, I think that's actually my stamina bar. Okay, guys, so I think I'm going to leave it here for this episode, but that was the Solus Project. Let me know what you think of it in the comments below. I think it's got a lot of potential, especially with us not really knowing what's going on. I'm actually quite excited to see where this game is going to take us. I think I'm going to make another episode of this because I definitely want to delve a little deeper into what's going on this planet. But if you did like this episode, don't forget to drop a like. It's the quickest way of letting me know that you want more of this. And as always, guys, thank you so much for your support. I'll see you all in the next one.